A well-structured workflow is really important because not only will it help you keep tabs on where you've put your images, it will also help you manage the way in which you work through them, hence the word workflow. Everybody's going to have their own preferred way of doing things. For example, my friend and colleague Bella West showed me the way she did things. I adopted her system, and then over time it kind of evolved and changed shape a bit to the way I like to do things. So what I'm going to do is to show you the way I do things and explain why I do them the way I do, and maybe make a few suggestions for how you might want to change the way I work to suit yourself. I've got some image files here on a flashcard out of the camera, which I will be loading in a minute. But before we do that, we've got to make a place to put them. We've got to create a workflow for those images to go into. So if I open up the hard drive where I keep my image files, you'll notice that everything has a number followed by a name. This one here, for example, Thatched Cottage, 1236. Thatched Cottage. It's job number 1236 and the client is the Thatched Cottage Restaurant. I need a file number because I do it for a living.